Right. Hello. My name's Mark Automaton. Not my real name. I was in a band many, many years ago with Protag called the Instant Automatons. And I'm going to do a few of our songs. Now, originally, it was going to be me and a guitar and a drum machine, but the drum machine has decided to have an attack of amnesia, and it's lost all the programs that I put in, so it's just going to be basically me and the guitar, so sorry about that. Okay, this first song is called Nice Job for the Lad. Jimmy left school at 16, he wanted to learn a trade. Teacher said that he was bright and then thought he should have stayed. When he joined the army, his parents didn't feel bad, and everyone agreed it was a nice job for the lad. Nice job for the lad. Was marching along, there were people cheering and waving flags and singing patriotic songs. And all of the girls kissed the boys goodbye, and 100 brass bands played. And the sun shone down, and everyone thought it was a nice day for a parade. Nice day for a parade. There's a humming in the distance from the bombers coming back. They've been flying all night through the rain and the flak. Jimmy's bomber won't come back anymore, as the generals thought it was a nice day for a war. Nice day for a war. They were standing at the graveside, staring at their shoes, nobody knowing what to say or do. They were all dressed in black, surrounded by the dead. Nice day for a funeral, somebody said. Most of the Instant Automaton songs were written about 30 years ago, and they have become somewhat of their time, but that particular song remains depressingly topical. Yeah, sure. This song is called Emma.
Describing being you, what is the reach or aim, Emma? Now the night is dark and still, Emma. Balance on your windowsill, Emma. Now you're safely tucked in bed, flashing lights inside your head, Emma. Stand and watch the rain fall, Emma. through the window pane falls Emma. Emma's playing with her toys, Emma's playing with the boys, Emma. You scream and split the night in two, Emma. Although you know it was not you, Emma. Some people gather round to stare as music fills the midnight air, Emma. The moon is shining in the sky, Emma. Close your eyes and you goodbye, Emma. Though you waited much too long, you finally got into the song, Emma. Emma.
Sunday afternoon. There are some copies on the table over there. They're £5 each. All money goes towards the Marie Curie Hospice. So please, bye bye bye. This is called Violence. I
was sitting on the front porch, I was waiting for the rain and you would come. Another day, another year, and yet another wasted Sunday afternoon. I saw you walking down the road with some flowers for a grave that could be mine. I should have stopped and said hello or something, but I have so little time. Talk is small in grocery stores, our size are deep in libraries and basements. Our nights along our minds are filled with wondering if there will be more violence. I could write a book a million words, but no one wants to read books anymore. So just fill your glass and turn your back and make your way across the dancing floor. You start to win could be the place where I begin to lose. So take off your silver spangled satin ball gown and learn to be my friend. But if that is too difficult, then I suppose that we could just pretend.
Tradition in the Instant Automatons of doing cover versions, so I thought we'll do a cover version for this particular set. The song that I've chosen though is not one that we did during the lifetime of the band, but it is one that was written by one of Protag's favourite singer-songwriters, Loudon Wainwright. This is called Motel Blues.
Motel room, treat me nice. I don't want to stare at these ugly grass mat walls. Chronologically, I know you're young, but when you kissed me in the club and you bit my tongue, I'll write a song for you, put it on my next LP. Come up to my motel room and sleep with me. There's a Bible in the drawer. Don't be afraid. I'll put a sign up to warn the cleanup maid. There's lots of soap and there's lots of towels. Never mind those desk clerks' scowls. I'll buy you breakfast. They'll think you're my wife. Come up to my motel room, save my life. Come up to my motel room, save my life. Is a jolly little ditty about weird music, and you may find that you want to clap and sing along, but please don't, because it's really annoying. 1, 2, 3, 4. I was in a pub the other night when a bunch of mutts came in. I'd be up, then they came over, they said, hey, what's your scene? Are you a hippie, a mod or a punk? Got a scooter or a motorbike? I can't understand why they burst out laughing when I told them the music I like. People laugh at me cause I like weird music. People just don't understand. Why the six member and I'll be when you can. Now listen to a weird noise band for free. Let's listen to a weird noise band. I had a girlfriend called Josephine. She liked ABBA and the Bee Gees. She thought music was about lawyers and accountants, percentages and legal fees. Just the other night, we stayed up late, playing records till 10:30. Then I saw a Danny and the Dressmaker's tape, and I never saw Josephine again, because people laugh at me, cause I like weird music. People just don't understand. Why does it come for an album when you can? Listen to a weird noise band for free. Let's listen to a weird noise band right now. Let's listen to a weird noise band. Listen to a weird noise band. Listen to a weird noise band. Listen to the 012. Listen to the androids of Mew. Listen to a weird noise band. Let's listen to a weird noise band. Thank you. This next song is called Short-Haired Man in a Long-Haired Town.
when I wrote it, I had the option of short hair or long hair. Now, not so much. Riding on a bus, all people were staring at me. I was riding on a bus, all the people were staring at me. I said, conductor, conductor, won't you tell these people let me be? Up comes the conductor, he's got a pink cap on his head. The conductor's got a peek on his head. He pointed his finger at me and this is what he said. Now you're a short head man, this is a long head town. Now you're a short head man, this is a long head town. Till you let your hair grow, everybody's gonna push you round. I went to the local college to study for a degree. I went to the local college to study for a degree. The college professor, he said, we've got no vacancies. Cause you're a short head man, this is a long head town. You're a short head man, this is a long head town. And they tell you that your head grew, everybody's gonna push you round. I went to the local boozer to get myself a beer. To the local boozer to get myself a beer. The barman looks at me, he said, you're not welcome here. You know why? You're a short head man, this is a long head town. You're a short head man, this is a long head town. And until you let your hair grow, everybody's gonna push you around. Well, people always try to change you, don't ask me the reason why. Well, people always try to change you, don't ask me the reason why. But I'll be a short-haired man till the day I die. Yeah, I'm a short-haired man. Long-haired town. I'm a short-haired man. This is a long-haired town. But until I let my head grow, everybody's gonna push me round. But I don't care. National Museum of Musical Curiosities. It's the original and genuine Instant Automaton's Woolworths 8-stringed Top 20, which was played on the song that I'm going to play you now. If you were listening to the John Peel show in the early 1980s, and let's face it, who wasn't, you may have heard this song. It's been described as a song about love, death, and household appliances, and it's called John's Vacuum Cleaner. I'm trying to remember the words. John spent his time in hotel rooms in countless dreary towns, living a travelling salesman's life, doing travelling salesman's rounds. He was married to Jill, a very nice girl, a faithful through and through. He was planning for a family and they had a pay rise due. But when Jill left with John's best friend, he couldn't accept the fact. He cleaned the house night to day, just waiting for her to come back. He bought a vacuum cleaner from the man who lived next door. Spent his night tidying the rooms and vacuuming the floor. John's vacuum cleaner was his only friend. John's vacuum cleaner, his companion to the end. John told of his troubles as he cleaned up tirelessly. John's vacuum cleaner, it hummed in sympathy. The television, it didn't work, it got broken late one night. He tried to fix it once himself, but he couldn't put it right. Washing machine and the freezer too had something wrong with them. And only the vacuum cleaner presented no problem. John's vacuum cleaner was his only friend. John's vacuum cleaner, his companion to the end. John told of his troubles as he cleaned up tirelessly. And John's vacuum cleaner, it hung in sympathy. John was found dead in his car, he didn't have much of a life. Lost his job, lost his cash, deserted by his wife. He turned the key, he choked to death on carbon monoxide. The milkman found his body, the papers called it suicide. For when the police searched his house, they found it bright and clean, with nothing to suggest that his mental state was not what it should have been. And in the cupboard, under the stairs, leaning against the wall, they found a vacuum cleaner, which did not work at all. Thank you.